Liberty of abode and travel. Okay? So, well, let's take a look first doon sa case ng Kaunka versus Salazar. Itong case na to, ang issue dito was whether or not itong maid, okay, yung katulong, meron siyang right to transfer to another residence even if hindi pa siya nagbabayad ng amount advanced by an employment agency, which was then detaining her for her transportation from the province. So, yung respondent, sabi niya, she could not. Okay, hindi daw siya pwedeng umalis doon sa bahay. Dahil hindi pa nga nabibigay yung bayad niya. So, the Supreme Court ruled otherwise. Sa petition for habeas corpus, yung petitioner's liberty of abode was sustained and her detention was declared unconstitutional. So, sabi ni Justice Perfecto sa case na to, yung employment agency, regardless of the amount it may advance to a prospective employee, wala siyang absolute power to curtail, napigilan yung freedom ng employee na yun. Okay? Yung power to control freedom may be an effective means of avoiding monetary loss to the agency is no reason for jeopardizing the fundamental human right. Okay, hindi porket well, magkakaroon ng loss, money loss dun sa agency is gaganyanin mo na yung tao. Okay? Hindi reason yon. The fortunes of business cannot be controlled by controlling a fundamental human freedom. Okay? Human dignity is not a merchandise appropriate for commercial barters or mga business bargains. Fundamental freedoms are beyond the province of commerce or any other business enterprise. So, in the scale of values, there is no acceptable equivalence between matters involving human dignity and those na nagbebelong to the domain of business. Okay? Yung domain of business are characterized by transience and precariousness. While yung human dignity are the nearest things to what are everlasting, if there are any, sa humanity. Okay? Human dignity and human freedoms, essentially spiritual, notwithstanding their material manifestations sa external world. And the universal concept of the spirit is inseparable from the idea of the eternal, of the unlimited by space or time. So, money, power, domination, satisfaction of the pleasure of the flesh, like all lusts, belong to the ephemeral and perishable, an order of things which has no possible equation with the moral values ng spirit, among which are human freedom. Okay? So, the views, etong human, liberty of abode and travel, makikita natin to sa inaffirm to ng Section 6 ng Bill of Rights, providing as follows. So, the liberty of abode and of changing the same within the limits prescribed by law shall not be impaired except upon lawful order of the court. Neither shall the right to travel be impaired except in the interest of national security, public safety, or public health as may be provided by law. Okay? So, base pa lang sa provision na to, yung liberty of abode natin, hindi siya absolute. May limitations na nakalagay dyan. Okay? Yung liberty of abode, okay, yung liberty mo na manirahan kung saan mo gusto at lumipat ng bahay kung saan mo man gusto, may limitations yan. Okay? May impair yan except upon lawful order of the court. For example, destiero. Okay, so pag binan ka ron sa isang lugar, hindi ka na makakatira dun. Okay? May violation ba ng liberty of abode? No, wala. Neither shall the right to travel be impaired. Nai-impair din ang right to travel kung gusto mong pumunta sa ibang bansa, sa ibang lugar ng Pilipinas. Mayroong kakarapatan. Except na lang in the interest of national security, public safety, or public health as may be provided by law. Ayun yung limitations. Etong provision na ito is a rewriting of the original rule dun sa old constitution natin, which was confined to the liberty of abode. Okay? Itong bagong rule expressly includes the rights to travel and the exception has been restricted. Okay? So, ano ang purpose na itong right to travel na to? So, ang purpose is of the guarantee is no further emphasize the individual's liberty as safeguarded in general terms by the due process clause. Okay? So, yung liberty under due process clause, kasama dyan yung right to choose kung saan ka maninirahan, right to leave it, leave the residence kung kailan mo gusto, right to travel kung saan mo man gusto. Okay, itong Section 6 is a specific safeguard ng mga rights na to and is intended to underline their importance in a free society. Okay? In repressive regimes, one may not change his residence at will. The citizens cannot move from one part of the country to another, much less out of the country without the permission of the authorities. Okay? So yung departure niya from one locality must be previously cleared. Okay? Yung transfer niya to another registered, and if government says so, he may be shifted from one place to another against his consent. Okay? The idea is to keep tight rein on his movements and close track of his activities on the chance that he may be plotting against the state. Okay? Always chary of the movements of its subjects. The despotic government keeps an eagle eye on their comings and goings and places them under its close and constant surveillance para makontrol yung actions. Okay? So, like I said kanina, merong limitations. So, the liberty of abode and travel, subject yan sa specific restrictions na nakalagay din dun sa mismong constitutional provision sa Section 6. According dun, yung liberty of abode can be limited upon lawful order of the court. And yung right to travel by the requirements ng national security, public safety, or public health as may be provided by law. Okay, thus, itong isang tao na meron siyang criminal, may final ka sa kanyang criminal charges, pwede siyang ma-restrain ng court from leaving a country. Hindi yun violation ng liberty to travel niya. And kung nasa abroad siya, pwede siyang i-compel ng korte na bumalik sa Pilipinas. A lessee may be juridically ejected doon sa tiniterhan niya for violation ng kanyang contractual duties. Okay? The judge may prevent a person from entering certain premises under dispute or declared off limits by the proper authorities. Okay? So there is no doubt na yung health ng officers may restrict access to contaminated areas and also iko-quarantine nila yung mga already exposed to the disease sought to be contained. Hindi yun violation ng liberty of abode or right to travel. Kapag mayroong threat of volcanic eruption, for example, so yung mga residents doon sa paligid ng vulkan na yun, pwede silang persahin to evacuate and prevented from returning until the danger is over. Hindi rin violation yun. Okay? Sa US, it was held that the Secretary of State may regulate or even prohibit the travel of citizens to hostile countries to prevent possible international misunderstanding and conflict. Sa case ng Ruby versus Provincial Board of Mindoro, the respondents were justified in requiring the members of certain non-Christian tribes to reside in a reservation for their better education, advancement, and protection. Itong measure na to was held to be legitimate exercise ng police power. Pero dun sa case ng Villavicencio versus Lucban, the mayor of Manila was not sustained by the Supreme Court when he deported some 170 women of ill repute dun sa Davao. Okay? For the admittedly commendable purpose of ridding the city ng mga serious moral and health problems. So sabi ni Justice Malcolm dito, but one can search in vain for any law, order, or regulation, which even hints at the right of the mayor of the city of Manila or the chief of police of that city to force citizens of the Philippine Islands. And ito mga women na to, despite their being in a sense of lepers of society, are nevertheless not chattels but Philippine citizens protected by the same constitutional guarantees as are other citizens. Okay? So meron din silang, kahit pasabihin natin prostitute sila, meron pa rin silang karapatan to change their domicile from Manila to another locality. On the contrary, Philippine penal law specifically punishes any public officer who, not being expressly authorized by law or regulation, compels any person to change his residence. Also, in point is yung kaso ng Salonga versus Hermoso. So sa case na to, which was a petition for mandamus to compel the issuance of a permit to travel abroad, the case became moot and academic when the permit was issued before the case could be heard. But si Chief Justice Fernando nevertheless took the opportunity to declare as follows. Una, the present petition is likewise impressed with the moot and academic aspect. In the motion to dismiss ng Solicitor General noong April 21, 1980, it was stated na yung Certificate of Eligibility to Travel had been granted petition by dun sa petitioner. Yung Xerox copy was enclosed as a resolution for dismissal is therefore in order. So from the docket of this court, it appears that yung other petitions na katulad nito na na-file dati, namely yung sa petition sa Santos versus Special Committee on Travel Abroad, yung Pimentel versus Travel Processing Center, yung case ng Gonzales versus Special Committee on Travel. Doon sa mga cases na yan, there was no occasion to pass on the merits of the controversy as the certificates of eligibility to travel were granted. Then yung necessity for any ruling was thus obviated. Nonetheless, in view of the likelihood that in the future, this court may be faced again with a situation like the present, which takes up time and energy needlessly, it is desirable that respondent travel processing center should exercise the utmost care to avoid the impression that certain citizens desirous of exercising their constitutional right to travel could be subjected to inconvenience or annoyance. Okay? More telling was the separate opinion of Justice Tehangki. Sabi niya, doon sa case ng Salonga versus Medalla, after their in-public respondents in charge of the travel processing center had issued ng permit dun sa petitioner, the corresponding travel permit or certificate, niremark neto ni Justice na yung issuance of travel certificate necessarily is a recognition ng petition's right to travel under the present circumstances. Okay? So yung circumstances had not changed in any manner. Petitioner is the holder ng isang Philippine passport and valid yung passport niyon, and has urgent medical appointments and official engagement as the only Filipino member of the Board of Trustees of the United Board for Higher Christian Education sa Asia, based in New York. Okay? So yung huling trip niya abroad, somewhere 1980, without any complaint from any government agency. So sabi niya, walang valid basis for the delay in the issuance of petitioner's travel permit. Okay? And yung for his representative to have to follow in vain daily from the scheduled release date until he was constrained to file the present petition on April 18th as yung scheduled trip niya nung April 23 was in jeopardy. Okay? While all other applications had already been long acted upon favorably. So as the Chief Justice stresses in the court's resolution, it is desirable na itong respondent's travel processing center should exercise the utmost care to avoid the impression that certain citizens, desirous of exercising their constitutional right to travel, could be subjected to inconvenience or annoyance. Okay? Under the antecedents, with petitioner having previously established his right to travel as sanctioned by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, which duly issued him his passport, the petitioner has cause to complain that he should not be placed by respondents on their watch list without benefit of previous notice and hearing, so as to be afforded the opportunity to rebut whatever adverse information might have been complied or given in secret against him. Okay? So finally, it is not amiss to call the attention of the public officials concerned to the provisions of Article 27 ng Civil Code that any person suffering material or moral loss because a public servant or employee refuses or neglects without just cause to perform his official duty may file an action for damages and other relief against the latter without prejudice to any disciplinary administrative action that may be taken. Finally, it is not amiss to call the attention of the public officials concerned sa provisions ng Article 27 ng Civil Code natin that any person suffering material or moral loss because of a public servant or employee refuses or neglects without just cause to perform his official duty may file an action for damages and the relief against the latter without prejudice to any disciplinary administrative action that may be taken. So it is now required to avoid abuse by particularly by petty administrators with less than the proper regard for the Constitution that the ascertainment of the grounds for the exemption should be made by the executive officers only as may be provided by law. Okay? Specifying strict guidelines and appropriate standards. Okay? This is in keeping with the principle that ours is a government of laws and not of men. And also with the canon that provisions of law limiting yung enjoyment of liberty should be strictly construed against the government in favor of the individual. Okay? So, sa case ng Manotok versus Court of Appeals, yung petitioner who was on bail while facing several criminal charges for estafa, nag-file siya ng motion for permission to leave for the United States. Sabi niya, gusto kong pumunta ng US. Kasi meron siyang business transactions and opportunities. So, yung motion niya, dinenay initially. So, pumunta siya sa Supreme Court, in-invoke niya yung right to travel niya. So, his petition was dismissed on the principal ground na yung condition of the bail bond that he would be available at any time the court should require his presence was a valid restriction doon sa right to travel niya. Moreover, his reason for leaving was not urgent and it had not been shown that his sureties had agreed to his departure. Okay? Similar action was taken in the case of Miriam D. Santiago, who wanted to leave the country for educational purposes, and Rufa Gutierrez, who pleaded certain show business commitments abroad. So, sa case ng service exporter case, the Supreme Court had sustained an administrative regulation enacted pursuant to legislative authority temporarily suspending the deployment of Filipino female domestics abroad in view of the reports of their abuse and exploitation by their foreign employers. So, yung ban on the right to travel was justified on the ground of public safety. Sa case naman ng Marcos versus Manglapos, the Supreme Court, by an 8-7 vote, sustained the refusal ng government to allow the petitioner to return. Si Marcos, pinigilan nilang bumalik on the ground that it would endanger national security. Okay? So the majority held that there was sufficient basis for his apprehension, as against the minority's contention that the former president was like any other citizen entitled to come back sa sarili niyang bansa. Yung mga nag-deny ng petition were Chief Justice Fernan, Navarra, Herrera, Cortes, Aquino, Medyala, Regalado. Okay? Yung mga dispensers naman, si Gutierrez, Cruz, Paras, Feliciano, Padilla, Bidin, Sarmiento. Okay, so that is the right or liberty of Abode and travel.